Welcome to this series of videos about functional programming in Kotlin with Arrow. Arrow is a library that comes packed with lots of data types and type classes in order to bring type functional programming to Kotlin. Today, we're going to learn about the StateT data type, what it is, and how to use it.
StateT is a data type that is intended to handle application state in a functional way, while also allowing us to operate within the context of a different monad data type. One issue we face working with monads is that they don't compose. For instance, imagine we want to handle a mutable state with the state monad, but operations on our state can also fail, so we may also need to handle errors with the either monad. That provides a branching structure allowing us to differentiate errors on the left side and correct results in the right side. Combining these two structures will result in nested structures, and we may need to work with a needed boilerplate in order to operate with our state. Luckily, there's a really simple solution to avoid this issue. Let's see how to deal with all this with an example. We're gonna model a simple elevator, which is nothing but a data class containing an integer specifying the number of available floors and another one stating the value of the current floor. As you would imagine, our elevator is going to be able to lift up and go down, but we don't want it to crash on the ground or the ceiling, so our operations will support a series of errors in case we try to make it go beyond its upper or lower limits. The simplest approach will be to model these operations using the either monad. For instance, in order to lift up our elevator, we simply check its current floor and see if lifting it up will make it go beyond its limits. In that case, we return a left value containing the corresponding error. Otherwise, we return a right value with a tuple containing an updated instance of the elevator and the result of the lift up operation. We follow the same pattern to make our elevator go down. We check if the future position of our elevator, after applying the operation, will exceed its lower limits. If that's the case, we return an error. Otherwise, we return again an updated instance of the elevator and the result of the operation. So let's use these functions together now. We can use flatmap to operate within the context of each call returning either. In our case, we simply care about the updated instances of our elevators, so we are gonna ignore the results of our operations. Calling a new function on a three-stories elevator on the ground floor will succeed, as we'll make it go up two floors and then go down one floor twice. But doing the same on a one-story elevator will produce an error, as trying to lift it up two floors will exceed its upper limit. But until now, we haven't tried to keep and handle our internal state using state. This is when things get a little bit complicated. As you can see, just the signature of this example shows us that we have to deal with a nested structure, which will make it hard for us to combine it with other operations. But we can do better than this using the StateT monad transformer. StateT is defined in terms of F, representing another data type that provides an instance for the monad type class, S, which will contain our state, and A, which will be the result of the operations we perform to update it. The trick here is to use this F placeholder to correspond to our either data type. S will be our state, in this case, our elevator. And A will represent the different floors resulting from our lift up and go down operations applied on our state. Let's see new implementation for these methods using this monad transformer. Notice the function signature on both of them. Our updated operations work in the context of state T with the following type parameters, and either able to return elevator error, elevator as our state, and int. The body of our function, that takes the current state of the elevator as an input, is basically the same as in the previous examples, as we work with either types to return errors or correct results. The same is applied here to our go down operation. Notice how we haven't had to change anything in our implementation of the operation to work with a monad transformer like StateT. Let's see how we can use our usual available transformations to modify and combine the values contained in our StateT instances. As in state, we can also use map to transform the values we obtain from the changes in our state before we actually apply them. Let's transform the result of going down two floors to return a more printable result of the change in our state. Also notice how our error handling still keeps doing its job even after specifying our transformation. Monad transformers are monads too, so we can use flatmap to combine the previous operations. Notice how we don't worry about being under the either context or an state context. Each call will update the original state of our elevator. See how both in the success and error cases we get the capabilities of feeder to handle errors in our operations, together with the ability of keeping state in a functional way. Being a monad instance, it means we can combine operations with our state instances in a more imperative looking way with monad bindings. Each call to bind is a coroutine suspended function which will bind to its value after each state has been updated to their new values. Arrow also offers us ways to combine the results of several subsequent operations over a StateT instance by the use of the map operation within the context of an applicative. In our example, imagine that a user presses several buttons in an imaginary elevator. Thanks to the map operation, we can combine the results of these multiple stateful operations together with this. Notice how, if any of the operations fail, the map call will short-circuit and return an error. StateT has instances for the following type classes, allowing us to use all their associated operations: applicative, functor, and monad.
Today we've learned about the StateT data type in Arrow, what it is and how to use it. Arrow comes with several other data types and type classes in order to bring functional programming to Kotlin. You'll be able to learn more in next videos. Thanks for watching.